She has a deep love and heart for ministry, and she has a beautiful singing voice. Of course, today on Praise Him Now, we have Miss Edneese Wonyak with us. Don't go anywhere. Hello friends, Ryan Day here. Welcome to Praise Him Now, and we are just making our way through our second season. This is episode number 3, and we're excited to have Miss Edneese Wonyak in the building today. Yes. How are you, Edneese?
I'm doing well, Pastor Day. How are you?
I'm great. For the longest time, I was calling you Edneese. I don't know why, because I guess I've heard and seen other people's names spelt similar, and they pronounce it Edneese, and I've been calling her Edneese this whole time, and not too long ago, she said, it's Edneese, so glad to have you here, sister.
Good to be here.
Yeah. Where are you from?
I am from Ohio, Central Ohio, so raised there. I was actually born out east, northeast, but been in Ohio most of my life.
All right, awesome. It seems like it was just a few weeks ago, although it's been probably a few months now, but you were one of the people that originally reached out to me when we were planning to hold a special youth event at the Eastwood Seventh-day Adventist Church. We had Noah Logan last week, and so we've now got Edneese, who was in that group that I told. If you didn't watch last week's episode, you got to go back and watch it. Noah had the talented Noah Logan. And in fact, he stayed over this week, and he's with us this week. He's going to be helping us out here in just a little while in our game segment when we get there. But just a talented group of people there in the Eastwood area at the church there in Columbus, Ohio. And I heard you sing, and your voice is beautiful. And I started immediately taking notes, and I started taking people's names down. I'm bringing that person out. And it's just a blessing to have you here, and you're going to be sharing a song with us today.
Yes,
so.
Yes.
Yeah. All right. So let's talk about your past and your upbringing. Mm-hmm. Have you always been a singer? How long have you been singing?
I started singing kind of late. So I've always been a pretty shy, quiet person. When I was younger, I was in like youth choir, but I didn't sing my first solo till I was about like 19, 20.
What?
So yeah, I've started kind of late, and I've been blessed to be around people who've encouraged me as well.
Right.
So as you mentioned, at Eastwood, we have a lot of musicians, a lot of people there. So that kind of got me started, and I'm here.
Man, that's amazing. So you started, you said, what age now?
Like 19, 20.
19, that is amazing.
Yeah.
So like, I have a friend who very similar to this, who didn't start singing until like his senior year of high school. Mm-hmm. And he's an incredible singer. And it's hard for me to wrap my mind around people who develop that late, because I've been singing since I was 2. Mm-hmm. And so, I mean, it's something that you're born with, I think. I think God invests that within you, but perhaps maybe it just wasn't, God didn't bring that to you as an interest, or you weren't motivated to share that gift until 19.
I think also the shyness for me. Like, I'm very shy, so I guess with age, it's still kind of there, but it's kind of backing away. So if I wasn't as shy, maybe I would have started a little earlier. But I did start off with piano lessons. So my dad had put me in piano lessons when I was younger. Fortunately, that didn't go too far. But with singing, I've always loved music.
Right.
Like, I've grown up listening to music. And I would just kind of play around and sing.
Mm-hmm.
And then, of course, my parents put me in youth choir. And then from there, I kind of got a little more confident with it, and again, found some people at church who encouraged me with it as well, and it led to something bigger.
Praise the Lord. Well, you're doing, no one would be able to tell that you're shy. You're doing a fantastic job so far.
Praise the Lord.
I'm just excited to have you here. I love your voice. You have a very graceful, just beautiful tone to your voice, your vibrato. Everybody has a different taste, and that's the beautiful thing about music, is it's an art, and not everyone necessarily may care for the same type of art. Mm-hmm. Some people can look at a painting and love and fall in love with the painting, and then other people can look at that same painting and be like, ah, it's not really my taste. Mm-hmm. And I find that music is that way as yeah, well. Everyone has a different like, a dislike, or a preference when it comes to music right. and tone and vocals. And for me, to me, vibrato is a big thing to me. I just, there's certain types of vibrato I just don't care for. Mm-hmm. But your vibrato is very smooth, it's very natural, and you just have a beautiful singing voice, a beautiful
Praise
tone. And so
it's
a blessing to have you here, and I'm excited that you're going to sing for us in just a little while.
Looking forward to it.
Yeah. And so do you, last time I met you, you were traveling.
Mm-hmm.
Do you travel a lot, or is it something?
I do.
Okay, so where are some of the places you've been?
So I've been like out east, Maryland, like out of the country. I've been to Brazil, of course Haiti, which I mm-hmm. believe we're going to get into some more.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I love to travel. I really do. If I could travel like all the time, I would.
Right. And your most recent trip was to Haiti.
Mm-hmm.
So tell us, how did that come about? What led you to want to go to Haiti?
Well, I am a first generation Haitian American. My parents were born and raised in Haiti, and I have been fascinated with my Haitian background for as long as I can remember.
Right.
So it's always been a dream of mine to go back and serve, because I am grateful for the opportunities I have here, but I do acknowledge like where I come from.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm happy to say that I had the opportunity to go out there last August, and I spent almost a year out there. Mm-hmm. And it was a huge blessing. I learned so much there, and I thank God for the opportunity to fulfill this goal, this dream.
Amen. Amen. So in the Haitian culture, is music
it is, and especially like a cappella, and it was a blessing just singing out there. So I would sing at church out there, and then we also had, there was like this women conference going on,
mm-hmm.
women's conference, and I was there with some women from my church. And to evangelize, what we did was we went into the streets and we were singing like our hymns, some beautiful French hymns. And yeah, in Haiti, they sing with some, not to say we don't do that here, but they sing with so much power and so much passion there. So
nice.
It was a great experience.
Do you speak French?
I speak a little bit of French, but more so Haitian Creole.
Okay.
So French is like the official language of Haiti, but the language of the common people is Creole, and I'm fluent in that language.
Oh, give us something in Creole. Come on, give it to us.
Let's see.
I'm putting you on the spot.
I know.
It's okay, though. We got to hear this.
Let's say, merci pour l'opportunité que je me avais. That's thank you for the opportunity that I have to be here with you.
Wow, that's so beautiful. Yeah. I love it. So you sing in your native language
as
well?
Yeah.
That's cool. Yeah. That is awesome. So when you went there, how long did you stay in Haiti when you went?
I was there for about 10 months.
Whoa.
Mm-hmm.
So it wasn't just like a mission trip.
Mm-mm.
You went out there to stay for a few months.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Nice. Okay, so, I mean, when you were there, were you just there just to visit, or did you have a particular mission that you were there for?
Yeah, I was there with the mission group Beehive Global.
Okay.
And they are based in the central part of Haiti, and they specialize in agriculture, healthcare, and education. And I praise God, I was able to help out in all three of those aspects of the ministry.
Wow.
So one of the things, up until the time I had to come back, I was really involved in the primary school out there.
Mm-hmm.
So I was working with the first and second graders and kind of co-teaching that class.
Wow.
And that was a huge blessing. And we have a huge property out there where we have all types of crops growing. We have a community club that started when I was there, which to me really shows the heart of the Haitian people.
Yes.
Because this community club, it's called Combit, and Combit is something in the Haitian culture that started years ago, but with time it's kind of been dying down. But when I was there, we were trying to start it back up, because the whole point of Combit is I help you, you help me, so that we can advance.
Mm.
So for example, if a neighbor needs help cultivating their crop, I'll go out and help them. And then when I need help cultivating my crops, they'll come and help me. And then when we both see the increase, we'll share with each other.
Wow.
So it's a beautiful thing, and I'm so
happy.
That's
how it should be.
Yeah, exactly.
That's how it should be with
everything. Exactly. It shouldn't be like, I'm going to get ahead and leave you behind.
Yeah,
like,
this is mine.
We all this together.
Yeah,
yep.
That is so cool.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So while you were there, you said you led worship at the at the church you were at working in. And I know, do you also lead worship or help with worship at
Eastwood? I do. Yes, I do. I help with worship at Eastwood.
Mm-hmm. All right, man. Yeah, that is so cool. So let's talk about music ministry, because mm-hmm. I know that may not be what you do full time, but I do know it's a major part of your ministry and what you do at church mm-hmm. and in general. And so I just wanted to talk to you about what is music ministry to you, and how has it affected you over the years for you to be able to be ministered to and also to minister to others through music?
Music ministry to me, it's become a huge part of my life, and I mm-hmm. think it's helped me in so many ways, just personally. So kind of going back to the whole shy thing, after seeing like how the Lord could use me with music, it really helped me open up, and it helped me open up to new opportunities as well. Mm-hmm. So I was part of an a cappella group for a couple of years, and we got the opportunity to sing at ASI and GYC, right. And I've also done some solo yep. things as well, and have some good friends at Eastwood, one of whom is going to be joining you soon, Ted, yes. who has been a great help as well. And yeah, music has just been, a lot of times the songs that I'll sing, they're songs that like I really resonate with the words.
Right.
So it's, I praise God when people say that it's a blessing when they hear it, but also it's a mm-hmm. blessing for me, like when
absolutely.
I'm hearing it, it's reassuring me that like God's in control. Things may look crazy. We don't know where things are going,
right.
but he knows, like he's in control. So.
Amen. Yeah, music is it literally is, I guess you could say, kind of like my safe spot, my stronghold to
yeah.
kind of just break away.
Yep.
And I find myself throughout the day sometimes, and even moments like mowing my lawn. If you see me mowing my lawn, mm-hmm. I've got headphones on, mm-hmm. and you know, just listening to good music mm-hmm. While I do that, it's very therapeutic.
Yes.
And I find that music ministry is the devil comes in sometimes, and he will try to pervert anything he can that God meant to be used for good.
Yeah, yeah.
And so there's, when you think of music ministry, many people may think of, you know, like kind of like a worldly way of mm-hmm. which some churches try to carry that out,
mm-hmm.
You know, with the light shows and all those things. And I'm not saying lights are a sin or mm-hmm. that even certain musical styles are a sin, but it's more about the show. It's more about the presentation
yeah.
than it is, you know, the message behind the songs and
yeah.
the music itself that's supposed to bring joy and therapy.
Mm-hmm.
And so, just listening to your music and hearing you, I think it was your sister when I heard
yes.
she was playing for you
yep.
as well. I mean, it's very soothing,
yeah.
and God has gifted you with the ability to minister
Amen.
Through music, and I appreciate that greatly.
Amen.
Appreciate
Amen.
That greatly.
Yes,
and so, do you play any, you said you played piano, right? Do you play
I
any
did.
Other instruments?
I play the ukulele, so.
Oh, all right.
I kind of picked that up during the pandemic. I play that. And also I wanted to mention the song that my sister and I played when you came to Eastwood,
right.
that's an original song that we wrote years ago. So she plays and she wrote the music and created that. And then I wrote the words, and it's Psalm 70. So it's a beautiful song based on Psalm 70.
Absolutely. Wow.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord. No, you guys are just fantastic. And I just want to pick your brain for a moment, because I like to ask some of my guests this question. You know, it seems like in the culture and in the age that we're living in currently, that it's, you know, music kind of sometimes takes a back seat.
Mm.
Sometimes we prefer the spoken word over, you know, music itself. And I'm not saying that it doesn't have its
mm-hmm.
place, because it
mm-hmm.
certainly does. But what would be your response to someone who said, you know, music is not as important as preaching? You know, the message in preaching is a whole lot more important. What would be your response to someone if they were to bring that challenging thought to you? How would you respond to that?
Well, I would say that some people, they are moved by the music more than they are by the sermon.
Mm, that's it.
So some
it's
people,
me.
Yeah, right? Like when they hear a good tune, when they hear the words of the song, that can touch their hearts. Like everyone's different.
Mm-hmm.
So everyone's different. I know for me, when I hear a good song, that really draws me like to worship and things like that. And sermons do as well, but more so music. So some people I think are musically inclined, and that's how they really get the message and grasp like what's trying to be
yeah.
given throughout the service.
Absolutely, absolutely. And there may be a young person watching right now. I purposely started off this season with young people, you know, no discrimination against ages. We love all people of all different ages. But we started out with young people because I feel like there's a lot of young people at home that may be watching that they see you, they see Noah, they see Laura Williams, and they see these younger people who are taking that step of faith out there to put themselves out there to share their music. But someone at home right now may be a little discouraged and say, I don't really know how to get started. I'm a little shy. You've talked about you being shy. What would be your encouraging message to them?
I would tell them to keep in mind that God can do the impossible. Don't limit yourself. God has a plan, and he just needs you to move in faith, and he'll do the rest. So don't look to the left. Don't look to the right. Don't let things discourage you. Just seek him, and he'll make your path clear, and he'll let you know what to do.
Amen. Amen. Well, Anise, thank you so much for being here with us.
Thank you.
I'm excited, you folks. You can't turn the channel. You can't click away from this video wherever you're watching this, because after we come back in just a moment, we're going to play a little bit of a fun game. We're going to name that tune. We're going to put Ednice on the spot to see how many tunes she can name just by hearing the tune with no words. And then, of course, at the end of this episode, she's going to be performing a beautiful song for us, and you'll get to hear her beautiful voice. So don't go anywhere. We'll be right back in just a moment.
Jesus did it for me. I'm so glad Jesus did it for me.
If you're bound,
he will set you free, because Jesus did it for me.
What he said.
Hey friends, welcome back to Praise Him Now. We've been having a great time with Ednice Wonyak, and we are going to play one of my favorite games here on Praise Him Now, which is Name That Tune. And it's always interesting to see, and I love this game because, you know, it's interesting to see how people's brains work, because some people can hear just a few bars of a song, they get it, boom, they recognize it. And then sometimes a song that you've heard and sing so many times, but you hear just a little bit of it and it's hard to recognize it, or at least your brain is not computing it in that moment. So we're going to put Ednice on the spot,
right.
But we also have my brother from another mother, Mr. Noah Logan, with us. Welcome back, Noah.
It's good to be back.
It's a blessing. He's helping us out here today on the piano. So you're going to be providing the tune for us. And we've got a list here, Ednice.
Yeah.
All right. I'm going to show you the list. Are you ready? I'm going to give you a peek at it.
Okay.
Are you ready? Boom. There it is. That's all you get right there. All right. So we're going to start out. And I'm going to basically give Noah the cue. And he's going to give you just maybe a couple of bars, three or four bars of a song.
Okay.
And then you got to decide what you think that song is.
Okay.
Some of these are probably going to be easy. Some of these may be not so easy. But we'll see. We'll see what we have. So take it away, Noah. Number one.
Above all power.
Boom! Oh, man, that was so great. I love it. That was great, man. Great, great, great. Above all, that was the first one. All right, the next one, let's see. Let's see if you know this one.
Oh, yeah. I love the Barney song.
It's the Barney theme song. I love you. You love me. All right. That was great. All right. Take it away. Number three.
Blessed Assurance.
Blessed Assurance. Wow. Wow. All right. Man, you're doing good at this. I'd still be thinking. We played this game not too long ago, and I couldn't think of anything. Tim was over there on the piano, and he's playing it out perfect. And they're all looking at me like, bro, how are you not getting this? And my brain couldn't think of it. All right, number four, take it away.
Twinkle, twinkle.
All right. Just not. All right. We have to make it a little bit more. Make it a little more difficult for her. Noah, let's do that. She's doing too good. So this time, just do one note at a time, and let's see if she still gets it. All right. Here we go. Let's do it as well.
Wait. You said it though. Was that a trick?
I told you what it was when we started. That's totally. I was just gonna see if you'd still get it. All right, here we go. The next one.
Come thou fount.
Come thou fount of every blessing. Wow. All right, the next one.
Mary had a little lamb.
All right. Let's see if he gets the next one.
Jingle bells.
All right, now this next one, let's see if you can get this one just by, go ahead.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul.
What? That, how did you get that one? Like, I think Tim played something similar to that. I think it was that song, and I had to hear it and listen to it over and over. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. That's the beginning of the song is 10,000 Reasons. That's the name of the song. Yeah. All right, let's go to the next one.
Can I hear it?
I think we got her.
Wait. One more time.
I think we got her.
Oh, shout to the Lord.
Oh, she got it. All right. That's good. All right, next.
Then sings my soul. How great thou art.
How great thou art. Good job. All right, let's go on to the next one.
Joy to the world.
All right. Oh, now this next one, I probably wouldn't get this next one. Go ahead.
I'm coming back to the heart of worship. It's all about you.
Man, Edness, you are knocking this out of the park. I'm going to have to get, when you can't come back, I'm going to make it more difficult for you. All right, let's do the next one.
As the deer.
What? All right, she's just going through these like crazy. All right, let's do the next one.
Jesus loves me,
this I know, yes. For the Bible. All right. Oh, let's see if she can get this next one.
He's got the whole world.
All right, and the next one.
Oh, how I love Jesus.
Oh, man. I think it's just his playing is just so beautiful, and he's so spot on. All right, let's hit it. Let's get the next one.
I cannot tell.
No.
Wait. Yeah, okay. You raised me up.
You got it, girl. All right, the last one. We got a few seconds. Hit it.
When we all get to heaven.
You got it. Oh my goodness. Folks, look at that list. Look at that list right there. That is a lot. She got every single one of them. Praise the Lord. Good job, Ernice. All right, and what song are you singing for us?
I'm going to be singing Trust His Heart.
Trust His Heart. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Hello, friends. Ryan Day here. The 3ABN Praise Hill Music Network is always looking for fresh musical talent for our programs. Perhaps you or someone that you know has a musical gift you believe would be a tremendous blessing to our audience and bring glory to our God. If so, we encourage you to send us an unedited video clip of a musical performance to be considered by our music committee. Just send us a YouTube video link or a good quality video file to praisehim@3abn.org. Again, that's praisehim@3abn.org. We want to work together with you to continue to produce high-quality sacred music for the world and for the glory of our Almighty God. So God bless you all, and thank you.
Work for our good, though sometimes we don't see how they could. Sorrows that break our hearts in two sometimes blind us to the truth. Our Father knows what's best for us. His ways are not our own. So when your pathway grows dim and you just don't see Him, remember you're never alone. God is too wise to be mistaken. God is too good to be unkind. So when you don't understand, when you don't see His plan, when you can't trace His hand, trust His heart. Trust His heart. He sees the master plan, and He holds the future in His hand. So don't live as those who have no hope. All our hope is found in Him. We see the present clearly, but He sees the first and the last. And like a tapestry, He's weaving you to one day be just like Him. God is too wise to be mistaken. God is too good to be unkind. So when you don't understand, when you don't see His plan, when you can't trace His hand, trust His heart. He alone is faithful and true. He alone knows what is best for you. God is too wise to be mistaken. God is too good to be unkind. So when you don't understand, when you don't see His plan, when you can't trace His hand, trust His heart. When you don't understand, when you don't see His plan, when you can't trace His hand, trust His heart. Trust His heart.
God is too. I'm not gonna mention my age on the thing, are we?
Do what?
Are we gonna mention my age on the?
No.
Okay. Making sure.
She's like, don't you tell my age.
So when you don't understand.